right, guys, it's the bird and I here. We got a pretty good winch out guy. Spoiled leg. I guess he tried to swerve to avoid the deer. All right, Jay, I'm going to pull up a little bit here. So we're going to use a side puller winch. Well, yeah, actually, it's probably fine right here, bird. We're gonna run the drag line to back there, low over here to this leg. So it's cool. Yo, what up? Yeah, where's John at? Where's John at? Yo, hey, this guy's down in a ditch, so. I mean, I'm gonna try, but if something starts to get hairy. No, you can just hold off on that for now. Where's the other tater? Oh. I thought you were, well, I guess Chris was in that picture when you sent it to me. Tell me why Chris's helper don't look exactly like him. Standing just like him and everything. I was like, wait a minute, which one's Chris? Alright, well, I'm going to try to pull this thing out. He's leaning pretty good, so. Alright. Did you just release the brakes? I'm 30. I've been doing it just about a little over 10 years.
That time I ran off the road in 1992, a guy hooked it to my landing gear.
Yeah.
And I was just the steer tires. A woman jumped in front of me and made it stop real fast.
Uh-huh.
I went to stop and I went up off the road to miss her. I was fucking would have killed the kids in the back seat.
Yeah.
He hooks me up to the thing and pulls me right through it. I said, dude, all you do is pull me back. He made it hard to handle, so he pulled me through the shit.
Oh, really?
He said, just my steer tire was stuck in the ditch.
Oh, yeah.
And the trailer was up on the thing and on the road. I almost got it pulled out with another truck, but he came back empty.
Yeah.
I needed weight.
Hey, try to pull that cable, Jay. This ain't free spooling for some reason, bird. Pinched. This one's pinched. We need to pull this one out. Pull it. I'm letting it out. Pull down on it. stuck? Preschool? Fuck, here. Here, put it on this leg. We're gonna hook it to that leg real quick. No, hook it to that leg. Hold on, I'll get a fucking chain. See if it's free now. Okay. It should be free now. Easy, easy. Let's pull it together. They're just pinched in there. We're gonna double back to the foot, so go past this truck. I think that's probably good, maybe. Whew. No, we're just gonna use one.
Do I mean the truck before you pull it?
Please, yes. The reason reason I say that, so you can steer it,
right.
Hit the brakes if anything's, you know, failing or something. Getting freaking hot, boy.
I don't know. First day back on vacation.
How's that snatch block? How's that snatch block? Make sure that spools in good. You got the brakes released?
Yeah.
Okay. Go see how much more room I got up front there. I'm gonna see if I can't just pull on the trailer and see if it won't pull them forward. Tell them not to hit the brakes. Tell them not to touch the brakes. Don't touch the brakes. Go ahead, take that off. I'm gonna just pull you up. I'm gonna want you to turn away from my outrigger there, okay? Tell him to go straight. Straight. Yeah. Got a little bit of fifth wheel gap there. You know, we got a little bit of gap there. I like to think we're pretty good. Oh, and there we have it, boys, ladies and gentlemen. We were able to put the side puller winch on them. We gotta get some earbuds or like some walkie-talkies so we can hear each other. And I know you got the guys on this side looking at me. All right, if you want to just pull up and get out of the ditch right there, just pull up in front of me, and then we'll put all this stuff away, and I'll call my dispatch. You know, some people might have looked at that and been like, oh shit, this thing's about to roll over because he slid so far down. But you know, I know it. We got him out. He's ready to rock and roll. Bird and I did a good job getting him out. Pepe LeBird, good job on the winch out. I think we did that with the perfect amount of room here. For what we were doing. You want to fold it? Thank you. all the time, unfortunately.
Derailleur related or just kind of driver stupidity?
Actually, before they blocked that off down there, I pulled a Snyder truck out of down there. I'm gonna fold that up there. I didn't want to scare you.
Snyder's at all. Kind of a rookie.
I think that's exactly what it was. He was green. There's a field down there. The ditch is probably like similar to that. And he drove off of it and he tried to, go down and turn around on the field. And as soon as he got the tractor down, luckily for him, he was empty. So it wasn't too bad of a pull, but we only had to put one line on him. And I just put the drag line on him and pulled him pretty much just straight back. Cause really his tractor was the main thing that was stuck there.
Years, the first time I've done this.
Well, yeah.
If I have a deer, I should just hit the damn thing.
You must have been
off the road for a second, man.
Hey, it happens.
I felt like a rookie when it did it, man.
You know, it happens. I mean, I know people, I've pulled guys out of the ditch that I've been driving 40, 50 years, shit just happens, whatever.
It happens. One time it happened before, I was telling you about it, because the woman passed me, I was on 251, it's a two-lane road.
Yeah, I know about 251.
She drove by me, and then she hit the brakes real hard, and I had no brakes on the trailer.
No.
My boss brought a trailer to a spot in the drop yard where the brakes were out. I stood on those things, I wasn't slowing down, so I kind of swerved. I had a real steep ditch, and I kind of just passed her up. I'm halfway past her, and I stopped. And she had three kids in the back, and it was a pinhole. I remember the car like it was yesterday.
Yeah.
I've seen these three kids.
Oh, old ass. This happened some time ago.
Back in 1995.
Yeah, Pinto you're talking about. That's old.
There's a black woman with three kids in the back. What the fuck's wrong with you, lady? That's a high speed, 55 miles an hour.
Yeah. Tap the brakes, that's gonna happen, right?
The steer tire got stuck. I was on the road. The drives were on the road and the trailer was on the road. By the time I got faster, I'd say her car was right here. If I would have hit her, I'd have killed everybody in that car.
Oh, yeah, for sure.
And my boss said, you should have hit her. I said, I'm not going to kill a bunch of kids, dude. I'm going to fire me over, fine.
Come on. That's.
Well, this guy was
That's a rough thing to be asking for, you know? I'm going to just phone my dispatch real quick, see what we're doing here. They got to review the photos and check the GPS and all that. Yo, what am I charging for this?
Michael, yeah, good one, all right? Well, folks, there you have it. The bird and I, we did a successful winch out. Luckily for us, it went as planned. We were able to get him out of there, out of the mud. There he is right there, out of the ditch right here where he came out of, which you guys already know. So we will, so we'll catch you guys on the next one. Bert and I hopefully will get a rollover maybe, and we'll just do a rollover to ourselves instead of these simple winch outs. Thanks as always for watching.